Hi, let us understand how to limit the resource utilization by any container. Within a host, n number of containers can get started and each and every container will be utilizing the resources available within the host. When it comes to the resources, mainly it's going to utilize the CPU and the memory. So each and every container will be utilizing the memory and CPU available within that specific host. By default, when it is getting created, it is not going to limit itself on how much it can utilize from that specific host. And I can go ahead and update, or while starting the container, I can limit the resource utilization as well. Let's go ahead and see a small demo. Let me start a container without any limitation and see what's going to happen. So let me start a container, Docker container run in the detached mode. The name of the container, I'll call it as Nginx limit test 1, and the port mapping, I'll map the port 6051 to the port 80 of the container. So the container will get started. Now I do have the command called stats, docker container stats. So that's going to provide the information on how much CPU it's being utilized and how much memory it's being utilized. For example, in this case, it is utilizing 2.145 MB out of 3.85 GB. The entire host is having 3.85 GB of memory. Let me go ahead and start another container, limit test 2, and map it to a different port and check the memory utilization. So here, if you observe very carefully, the entire 3.85 GB is available for the first container as well as the second container. Whoever is utilizing first, the memory will be allocated to that specific container. So the container which is going to utilize more memory will hold the memory, and the other containers may get restricted on the memory utilization. For this purpose, we can go ahead and limit how much amount of memory or CPU can be utilized. First, we will see how to control the memory. So let me go ahead and start a container with memory limitation, Docker. Using the same Docker run command, I am going to add the memory utilization. So let me start a new container and map it to the port 6053. Here, I will be adding the details on memory. So the option is dash dash memory, and I'll restrict it to 180 MB. That means it will have freedom to utilize 128 MB of memory from the host. Let me go ahead and see the statistical information. So maximum it has limitation to utilize 128 MB of memory. Beyond 128 MB, it cannot utilize. Either it will get terminated or it will not seek for more memory beyond 128 MB. At the same time, I can go ahead and update the memory utilization as well. Let me go ahead and update the memory utilization to 256 MB. Docker container update memory to 256 MB, and I want to have restriction on the swap memory as well. Let that be 256 MB on the container. Let me give the container name. So this will get updated. Let me go ahead and see the stats. So it got updated to 256 MB as the memory limitation. Now I can see more details using the inspect option, Docker container inspect, and then the container name, where it is going to provide the entire details about that specific container. This is having huge amount of information, so I can go ahead and grip the required information only. Let me go ahead and do the inspect of that container. I'm going to pipe the output into grip, and I'll filter only for the memory. So here I do have the details on what that we have set for the memory swap and the memory. In case if I wanted to grip on the CPU, I can go ahead and grip only the values corresponding to CPU. So here I do have the values corresponding to the CPU. Next, we are going to see how to restrict the utilization for the CPU. Before getting into the CPU utilization, how to mention the CPU shares. Let's have a quick understanding. In memory utilization, I can mention the quantity in terms of MB or GB. For CPU, I cannot mention any quantitative value, so I need to mention it as shares. Say for example, container 1, if I am saying 1, it's going to have a share of 2, and container 2, it's going to have a value of 2 shares, and container 3, it's going to have a share of 3 shares. So what that means is the entire CPU will be divided into 7 shares, and the container 1 will be getting 2 shares out of it, container 2 will get 2 shares out of it, and container 3 will get 3 shares out of it. So irrespective of whatever the value that we are referring it to, that many number of slots will be made and that many number of shares will be provided for that specific container. And the limitation will come into picture only when it is crossing that specific limit of what share has been provided to the container. Let me go ahead and allocate the shares to the container. I can provide the shares while creating the container using the option dash dash CPU shares. Let me check the list of containers, docker container ls. Now I am going to update the Nginx limit test 3, which will have CPU shares of 2. Docker container update dash dash CPU shares of 2 for this specific container. I can check the shares details using the inspect option. Docker container inspect and then the name of the container, pipe it to grep for CPU. So CPU share, it is going to have 2. So what Docker engine does, it's going to sum up all the shares, and here the total CPU share is 7. So container 1 will get 2 shares out of it, container 2 will get 2 shares out of it, and container 3 will get 3 shares out of it. Using the same option dash dash CPU shares, I can go ahead and create the container directly as well. Let me go ahead and create a new container. Here I am going to restrict the CPU utilization CPU dash shares as 4, and let me change the name of the container and the port. Now I can do the inspect on this specific container, Nginx limit test 4. So it's going to have CPU shares of 4 out of whatever that is allocated for all the containers within that specific host. So in a quick summary, we have seen how to limit the resource utilization, especially in terms of CPU as well as memory for any container when we are starting, as well as how to update the CPU utilization and memory utilization once the container is up and running, and how to update them dynamically.